He's nuts. He's a crackhead. He's a crackcase. He's nutty little fruitcake.
Show
love. He's not a Judas who bought into it. You know, I said, you tell me, you give me some silver, I'll kill him. I'll get him, I'll make sure you get him. He was just, from William's point of view, he was nuttier than a fruitcake. That's,
people who beat Jesus, when they knew he did a fruitcake?
Well, when they said, yes, it was Jesus, I don't know what they're doing.
All right, then, do you think this man knew what he was doing?
Yeah.
No, the spirit knew what he was doing.
He knew what he was doing.
But he, as a human being, functioning heartbeat.
He knew what he was doing.
They knew what he was doing. Well, his tracks, if we can recover his tracks, it looks like he knew what he was doing. I mean, he knew how to make a bomb, he knew how to buy a rifle, he knew how to buy bullets. He knew how to do all that. I think he was taken over by a spirit, no doubt about it. Now, what do we do? Now, this is the kind of stuff that judges had to deal with. And now you're going to make the right decision. How do you know you're going to make the right decision? I mean, even today, if I was a judge, always with civil disputes, land disputes, to a murder, capital murder case, how would you sit there and you got the last decision and it's on you? Is there a way?
Fast and
fresh. Sister Charlie said fast and fresh, sure.
Well, decision is hard to make.
That's a tough call. We're going to put this guy down or not. Oh, should we hire this gay? Should we fire this gay person in the workplace? Civil. That's civil stuff. Capital punishment is another order. It's a civil guy. Civil suit dispute. Let my gay relative, friend, loved one have employment. Chick-fil-A, guy said, no way, here. So where you can't have your store in this city. So Chick-fil-A don't do. You're going to probably go to court and say that you can't tell me what city I can have my store. That's my First Amendment rights. I can put my business anywhere in America. Then the other folks say, yeah, well, we got discrimination laws. You can't discriminate. He says, yes, I can. See, I just fired the guy. Okay, Mr. and Mrs. Arbitrator, what you going to do? Judging.
That goes back to the Solomon.
Not
to cut the baby in half.
Yeah.
But he had to make a snap decision.
Yeah. I don't know if I'm making the right move, the right decision. Okay. Well, I'm trying to find a lesson in our book here. Oh, here it is. All right. Here's what Moses did, and it says there, the law was given by Moses. The law was given by Moses. Here's what the law does. It gives you access. That's all. It gives you access to get heard. Hope for it hears you. The law guarantees you access to justice, access to the arbitrator. And the arbitrator, he has to, although I'm seeing a lesson, the responsibility of the arbitrator, the judge, the final decision maker, he has to make sure that he's doing, that his decision is based on the law. And the law is all we got here, the first five books of the Bible. And he has to be brave enough to render his verdict and based on what Moses said. If this stuff come up, if you do this, if you maybe got this kind of discrepancy, he's going to turn to somewhere in the first five books of the Bible and he's going to show you the law says. Emotion, no emotions tied to it? No, nothing. Quick and goddamn.
What?
Cut the baby. Give them back the ring. That's what they got. That's what. easy way to be an arbitrator, the easiest way is to say, which one of y'all got the best? In America today, you're going to get as much justice as you got. Easy to decide the case. No sweat. That's how much justice you're going to get. When you run out of stuff, when you run out of access, so here it's different being that the arbitrator is supposed to base the stuff on God. I'll show you here. Justice is available to all. Okay, that's what it's set up. So to Deuteronomy 16 and 8. Deuteronomy. Where is that? It's in the first five books of the Bible, that's for sure. Let's go there and narrow your search. First five books. That's the law.
Sixteen and eighteen.
And before that, you see some things all the way from Deuteronomy 16 chapter. Every verse says, thou shalt not. If you do, thou shalt not. If you do. Then it gets to verse 16. I mean 18. What does it say? Someone read, please.
Judges and officers should make thee in all thy gates, which the Lord thy God giveth thee, throughout the tribes, and they should judge the people with just judgment.
Okay. Judges, officers, should thou make thee in all thy gates, and that's towns, cities, which the Lord thy God giveth thee throughout the tribes. Thou should judge the people with just, with fair judgment. Okay. He said it, but then he knew he had to turn around and say this. Verse 19. Thou shalt not wrest judgment, nothing to wrestle with. Like we wrestle with the question, should we put this guy down or not? You don't have to wrestle with it. Just flip and find it. What does it say? Oh. Somewhere in the Bible it does say, right, Brother Holman? Eye for an eye? And you? Well, we're going to read here in a minute. Blood for blood. Ooh, blood for blood. Whoa. You don't have to wrestle with it. It's written. That's what you do if you kill somebody. Somebody kills somebody, they bring them to you. Flip. Oh, that's what you do according to the law. Oh, boy. What does it say, verse 19? Thou shalt not respect what?
Thirds.
Neither take a bribe. for a gift. Don't take a gift. Mr. Judge, you can't take a gift from the people. Somebody bringing you gifts all the time. Can't take gifts. Why? For a gift blind the eyes of the wise and pervert the words of the righteous. The gift of this. Okay. That's the first qualification for a judge. You can't take gifts. Can't take nothing like that. You just sit there and you are an arbitrator. All right. So this is how we see that a judicial system was set up for God's people. And the judicial system is based on biblical law. Biblical law is different than the laws, state laws, local laws, state laws, Shirley's law, biblical law. It's different. It is different. Now, we say, okay, so if I'm going to be a child of God, then I got to go by the law. Ain't that hard? Is that hard? Kind of hard. Well, we have to. We take a deep breath. Blow out. Because Colossians 2 and 12 gives us a reprieve over here on this side of biblical law.
Okay. Well, God, excuse me.
Okay.
Deuteronomy 17 and 8.
Check it out. Go ahead, brother, I see you.
If there arises about a true horn for deed and judgment.
Uh-huh.
Between blood and blood.
My mind.
Between plea and plea.
My mind.
And between stroke and stroke.
My mind.
And rather controversial in these gates.
Yeah.
And said, they arise and get ye up into the place where the Lord God said to.
Yeah, that's a higher court. A higher court. See, he's setting up the judicial system, local, right here in the city. We got a decision, don't like it. Take it up to another guy. We're going to see him set up here in the lesson. Take it up to a higher court. You're going to keep moving it up to another high. You don't like that decision? Take it up to another higher court. That's what the Apostle Paul was doing when he was at Rome. All systems is kind of set up behind the biblical system. Not perfectly behind, but kind of like it. And Paul says, I'm a Roman, and you beat me. Yeah, you're a Jew too, but I'm a Roman citizen. And you
okay,
beat me.
I don't know all the numbers, but
okay.
Just tell me,
okay.
why did he say God shall chose?
He's the judge.
No, a place which the Lord thy God shall choose. That's because he's setting up the system, and the place is going to be a higher court within that region. A higher court. See, this is the reason why, because Moses sitting there all day long can't cover it. And Jethro told him, you're going to have to delegate this stuff. And some judges is going to make not a favorable decision. It could be a wrong decision, but the appealing process is there. And the next place is where the Lord chooses for a higher judge to go. A higher, a more experienced, better equipped referee in the law.
Yeah, verse 9 says, and thou shalt come unto the priests and the Levites and unto the Jews that shall be in those days and inquire, and they shall show to thee the sentence of judgment.
Yeah, so that's
I'm going to take it up higher and they'll show you.
So there it is, verse 9, there, brother. Unto the Jews that shall be in those days and inquire, and they shall show thee the sentence of judgment. So keep moving it up, and finally, some. Supposed to be in tune, I say living like the Lord wants them to live, judge, will trust that he'll make that final decision. Because he's living for the Lord. That's the requirement of a judge. Yes, sir.
In that way, in that sense, that God knows the heart of the person that he's going to put, he knows the heart of the person that he's going to put over that case.
He said that guy is supposed to be in tune with God.
Right.
And everybody should know that he's in tune with God, because when you're at that spot, that position, you're going to get some hard cases. So you better be following the Lord holy so that you can make the decisions that the Lord would make.
Matter of fact, in verse 10 and 11, it says, thou shalt do according to the sentence which they of that place which the Lord shall choose to show thee. And thou shalt observe to do according to all that they inform thee, according to the sentence of the law, which they shall teach thee, according to the judgment which they shall tell thee.
Thou shalt do.
Thou shalt not decline from the sentence that they shall show thee, to the right hand nor to the left.
In other words, it's going to be some hard stuff. Don't back off from what the law says. Question. Has America backed off?
Yeah.
Biblical law. Let's see.
Yeah.
As a country,
yeah.
Has America backed off the biblical law?
Yeah.
Ooh, wait.
Yes.
Especially that Sabbath one. You might not even put you there. That is so trampled on and disregarded. And now is it just suddenly? Oh, we just stopped doing it. No. It was gradually getting away from those biblical laws. Biblical laws. Concrete, black and white, ain't no ifs and buts, what's about it. We can take a deep breath. Us today. The only way you can get out of that, it's only one way out. Guess what that is? One way to escape this stuff. First five books of the Bible, but one way
grace.
To escape.
Yeah. Grace.
You yeah. cook if you don't.
Yeah.
Grace.
Well, I'm just thinking Romans 10 chapter right quick, but we're going to go to Colossians 2. That's where I was going to go. Just popped in my head, Romans 10 chapter. There's only one way out. Okay. 10 and let's go with verse 3. I'm talking about verse 4 and verse 5, Romans 10 chapter. How do I get in this mess that I'm in? I mean, it's the law. Somewhere Paul asked the question, is the law bad? Is the law bad? No, but then his requirements is on you. So he says, verse 4, for Christ is the end of the law of righteousness. To everyone that believes. For Moses described the righteousness which is of the law. Moses put this thing out. Here's how he's describing it. The man which doeth those things should be what? Live by it. You're in the law, you got to live by it. Oh, boy. How do I get out of this? Ain't the one way out. That's through Christ. Otherwise, the law got you. And what's it going to prove to you is that you could. Can't win. And that's why he said over there, don't back away from what the law says.
That's right.
Make a decision, man. Thou should not have thy neighbor's wife.
Yeah.
She sure is fine.
In that judgment, that's the reason. With the judgment that's going on here, does that also have to do with the punishment?
Yeah. The law, recognize the law, and here's the punishment when you break. Don't back away. Just cut the line.
So are we under punishment now?
If you're not under what?
Grace.
Again, if he says that, I mean, we look at kind of two laws, the law of grace and then the law of the land.
Civil law.
Yeah, civil law.
Okay.
Meaning that when a man can do something as heinous as this guy in Colorado, mm-hmm. God can forgive me, but he still has to face the law of the land.
He said civil law.
Yeah.
Civil law.
Is able to administer the punishment that is warrant for the crime.
And this is the thing about civil law. You can get away from it. I mean, you can kick it around and do what you want to do with the civil law. This can be manipulated.
Right.
But the law of the Lord, or the law of grace,
right,
is just cut and dry. And Paul says you're going to have to be under one of them. You're going to have to be under the law of grace or the law of Moses. And he clearly lays it out. Take your choice.
But isn't it both? Because God's law of grace forgives.
Yeah.
But man's law of the land says.
Civil law can be either kind. He
can say the death penalty.
Yeah.
Even though God's law is higher.
God's law is higher.
Right.
But will a people or a person subscribe to it necessarily?
Right.
They might not.
Right. But God's law gives him the ability to fall back in grace.
That's right.
Which is open to everybody.
That's right.
Because of what
Christ did. That's
so
right.
That law is absolute.
I don't know that law of grace is through what? Through Christ.
Right. That's absolute.
That's
and even the guy in Colorado has still the ability.
He still has opportunity, as long as he's breathing.
He's breathing.
To get under the law of what?
Grace.
Right. So now.
How can we choose to take
Because that's why God said judges, because he knew the people would be all over the place.
Right. But then at the same time, it's true, but at the same time, then they have to face the penalty.
Those people?
With the man of provoke if they choose the death.
That's what I see, and that's how God wisdom set it up that I gotta have a right judge, a righteous judge,
right,
to referee, because these people will do. They're going to get into stuff.
Right.
I mean, they're going to dispute. They're going to fight. They're going to get it. I got to have somebody there to referee, and he's got to have my mind when he makes that decision.
Right.
And I got to know that you there as a judge because you got my mind, my laws, my ways. You got them down. Moses was a perfect judge because he was what? After God.
Right.
But is he going to just setting up and telling everybody else, set up, it gets a little bit weaker, like the father gets away from Moses.
Ooh.
But they applying with the law, I mean, they trying to work the biblical law. And then he had to say, well, you make that decision, might not be the best one, go to a higher court. And hopefully that judge is even Stephen with the Lord.
But you know, on that, brother, not just you, brother, you know, serious problem, because it's very hard judge to really judge that. Like that right there. Yeah.
He never
was a lot of people.
In Colorado.
Yeah. And then, you know, whoever judge that, you know, it'll be very hard.
Yeah, well, the question is, how can you make sure you're right as the judge?
Right, that's what I'm saying.
Yeah, that's what we're going to study today. How can I make sure that I'm right as arbitrator?
But in that sense, like the people that he, the lives that he destroyed. Now, the law is set up for the person to receive justice.
Justice.
It's to receive justice. So are those people do justice for a crime that this guy committed by the law
justice?
Of the land? Yes.
Do they get justice? Now, right. God loves how many people?
All
people. So everybody got access to his throne. And that's called the throne of grace.
Yes.
That's it. Everybody got access. That's what justice does, gets you there.
Right.
Boom. But God could say it that I can't put it.
Right.
You might find at that throne where he says, I forgive you, child. I love you.
Yes.
My son died for you. Right. I forgive you. And of course, you have my grace. In any situation, you got my grace.
The judgment with him, isn't it just the punishment part? I mean, it's true that he did it, but then it comes to whether or not he goes death penalty, or will he be found insane?
It's insanity in the first five books of the Bible. Yeah, there's something in there about insanity. About the nut case. There is something in there. They got to go, but they got to find this nut case. What does it say about someone that's...
You know, one of the things I think too, Brother Donnell, is, and I said this before, but we see death as a finality, as being it, as being over, and God doesn't see it that way. It's not done at that point. So even this guy, like you said, as long as he's breathing, he has an opportunity to receive God's grace. And so you can see him later on in heaven. Right.
That's a possibility.
It's a very, very real possibility. Yeah. It's a very, very real possibility.
Escape penalty here.
But if he might have escaped the penalty here, but he wanted to escape a penalty with God. And that's the ultimate, and that's the final judge. And of course, all these situations we come across. And like I said, all those people that are killed, hey, you can see them again. Remember, God can kill and restore life as he deems necessary and as he wants.
Yeah. So why did God set up first? Like he created, and then he set up a law. Okay, Moses, law. For what? For people. Because people need, they got to have it.
Yeah.
They got to have an arbitrator. And so that's why. Now, I got to have a good arbitrator. That's the deal. Do I have a good, just arbitrator?
Right.
Mm. Now, so how can an arbitrator be sure that he's right? Throughout all these controversies? People like Jehoshaphat. The story of Jehoshaphat. Where do we pick that? And where can we find something about Jehoshaphat? 2 Chronicles 17. Yeah, 2 Chronicles 17. Would that be the that would be in the first five.
No,
I
mean.
17 and 12. Ooh, it's hot up there. Yeah. Maybe
it's
because
y'all got
me
under the jacket. That's fine. Okay. 17 and 12. Jehoshaphat waxed great exceedingly. He built in Judah castles and cities and stores. He had much business in the cities of Judah, and the men of war, mighty men of valor, were in Jerusalem. That's the capital. There are, and these are the numbers of them according to the house of Israel. I'll quote from verse 19. Of Judah, the captains of thousands, verse 15. Next to him was your house, Jonathan, the captain, with him 240,000. And we're going to look through all this prosperity, and we're going to go on down to verse 19. And these waited on the king, besides those whom the king put in the fenced cities. So, he had everybody, got your problems, bring them to the king, and the king would set up men to be the judges. Those people are going to get into the streets. I live next door to Brother Travis. Travis, cut down that tree. Won't cut the tree down. Bees blowing in my yard. Tired of Travis. I'm suing. Take him to court. Travis says, I can't help you trade the wind blow. It blows north, blows south. Sometimes I don't even know if it goes my leaves. Yeah, it says leaves this tree. We got to dispute. Everybody love the Lord. But we fight. Bumper, fender, bender. Stuff like that. All kind of everybody. And these are God's people.
Somewhere in Genesis, God said, if you take a man's life, if you spill his blood, then your blood shall be spilled.
Wow.
In the same way, if you murder someone, then that's going to cost you your life.
Ah.
So there's grace overriding, but what God said, you know.
Yeah, since how can I escape that?
Yeah.
I got to get off up under that. The only way I can get off up under that is what? He's not holding a gun to your head and saying, if you look, but he does put the pressure on you to say that you're going to accept what I've done for you, or you're going to have to answer to God's law. Every one of them is good. Every one of God's laws is good. You don't have to take what I did, or you don't have to deal with that.
It's only 10 of them.
Well, when there's 10, you know, 10 of them want to know, yeah, it's an old slew of them. And now the man who does not accept Jesus is going to have to. Okay, look at Colossians 2 and 12. That's, that's what the fool says, there is no God, I can live any way I want to. There's some laws for you to be down here, buddy.
Yeah.
They're God's laws. And then you're going to deal with them one way or the other.
Yep.
Okay, Colossians 2, 12 through 14. Somebody got that? Can read it.
Buried with him in baptism, and also you are risen with him through the faith of the operation of God, who has raised him from the dead.
Mm-hmm.
And you being dead in your sins and the circumcision of your flesh, have been put together with him, having forgiven you all trespasses.
How many trespasses? You trespassed. You broke. Go ahead.
Blotting out the handwriting of ordinance that was against us, which was contrary to us. And took it out of the way, nailing it to his cross.
Okay, that's what he did.
Yeah.
I mean, God had you dead right. There's your bed here. Next, there's your bed.
Oh, I don't want to go bed there.
Okay, so jump over to Romans 3. I do believe. Yeah. 3 and 10. This is what the righteous judges, this is what the arbitrator, any arbitrator would have had to come to the conclusion before Jesus.
Uh-huh.
It is written, there is how many?
Not one.
Verse 27, while we're here, where is boasting? It is excluded by what law of words made, but by the law of faith. Therefore, we conclude that a man is justified by faith without the deeds of the law. What? Yeah, you could have broke everything written. And if you get faith in Christ, justification. But then there's those that don't want to accept Christ, and then that's okay. That's all God's going to say at that day. All I got left is my law. Let's see how you deal with it. See how you deal with it? Oh no, I'm jumping in grace.
Chapter 4, verse 7 and 8 saying the
God.
Of Romans
4, 7 and 8.
I'm starting 6. Even as David also describes the blessedness of the man unto whom God imputeth righteousness without works, saying, blessed are they whose iniquities are forgiven and whose sins are covered, and blessed is the man whom the Lord will not impute sin.
Wait, yeah? Romans 3:23?
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
No, we all have
That's why the fool has said. Look, there ain't no way out of the law. What one way? Now, when you make your own moon and your stars and your mountains, and then we'll go by your stuff.
But if you say showing the grace of God, that can't any man really judge you the way that God's going to judge you. You know, the man going to judge you the way he want to judge you.
Well,
God going to judge you the right way.
Well, these judges back here in the first five books of the Bible that Moses set up and Jehoshaphat followed through, that they had to have a life to where they was in constant prayer and constantly in front of the world.
We'll
find that out later, and I've got to get to reading the lesson. And then when the matter came up, all they could do was just go to what the word says and look at the matter, and they say, "You ain't fitting in here. You're good," and that's up. And it took strength to do that. Let's read some of this lesson here. We'll see. Probably run out of time. Hope not. Okay, 12. Okay. All right. 2 Chronicles 19. Jehoshaphat dwelt in Jerusalem. He went up. He went out again through the people of Beersheba to Mount Ephraim and brought them back into the Lord God of their fathers. But he's got a revival going on. He wants the people to live right. And he set judges in the land throughout all the fenced cities of Judah, city by city. He set up a judicial system everywhere. Okay. And said to the judges, take heed what you do. And they ain't talking to everybody. He's just talking to who? The judge. For you judge not for who?
Amen.
And it's hard when you have to disappoint a brother or a sister. You lose. But we're neighbors. You lose. On what? What compassion? There's no compassion. It's what the law says. It's what it says, black and white. But that's my baby boy over there in Colorado. Don't kill him. The law says blood for blood. I mean, in favor of the death penalty. Nobody's in favor of it, but the law says you got to go. That's God's law. I mean, that's the biblical law. That's the biblical law. But then again, his way out is what? Through Jesus Christ. And once you get grace working on your side, ain't no telling what's going to happen.
Yeah.
You don't, because where sin abounded, did his thing, grace bounced you. He might get sentenced to it. I don't know. But I do know that outside of God's grace, he ain't got shot. He's a good turkey. He got to get grace working. Come through at the throne of grace where he can get help. I think it says mercy in time of need. Now, so You can't get society as a whole to feel like God would do, feel, see, and judge. But you might can get one man whom God can turn that heart in the right position to make the right decision. If that's the right judge.
So is, you got God's law and law of the land.
Now,
what you're saying is, I mean, I understand that the brother, talking about the brother in Colorado, he does have the chance to have access to God's law. Mm-hmm. But if justification as the law of the land,
well,
if he's sentenced to death.
See, this is what he has. He has a higher throne. There is a higher throne than the municipality of the court of generals. There's a higher throne than those. That's God's throne.
That's correct. But either way, I mean, the guy, either way, he could lose and he could win. He can win through God if he accepts God's grace.
Right.
And God miraculously has favor on a judge to say, okay, we'll give you life.
Yeah.
Or he wins by accepting what Christ has done, and he gained it in the afterlife.
Right. But if he don't accept, he lost.
Well, God is able to change the mind of that judge here on earth.
That's right.
Grace can work stuff that we don't even thought about.
Because, guaranteed, the law of the land could say that we want the death penalty in this case.
Yeah.
More life. And is it wrong? That's what we're saying.
Yeah.
Is it wrong?
Well, see, here we go. The law of the land. And the biblical law has ended.
Has what?
It ended.
Has ended for who?
Believers.
Can't touch it with the law.
That's believers.
The law of the land and the law of everybody else can't touch
it. It ain't for the criminals.
See, so the law of the land, even the law of the land, I should obey it, but it can't condemn me.
Right. That's the point.
The law of the land, the courts of the land cannot condemn me. I got a higher court.
Of believers.
Of the believers.
That believers.
I got a higher court. What? That's why Paul kept marching. I got a higher court. I should obey the civil laws, but they can't condemn me. They may verbally hit the gavel. Boom.
If they make the wrong decision on that, pull out.
See, God, man is man, and he's imperfect. He'll make a mistake, even the judge.
So if they give him the death penalty, he's really not supposed to get the death penalty.
But then you got to let grace, the throne of grace.
See, but that's the question.
That's the mercy seat has to kick in.
I mean, if he's a believer, he's under the law of grace.
Yes,
That's different.
That's different.
Now,
the law.
No. But you have to understand that there is law. There is civil law which, as Christians, you have to obey.
We should obey. But then you have to obey. The law of the land is not our final arbitrator.
But Santana, who gave man the law? Say, okay, I'm giving you the death penalty.
That's a civil law. Overtime.
I mean, they get here, like you said, the Bible was based, the law is based upon Bible principles.
Yeah.
In the Bible, if they committed adultery, then they was able to stone them to death.
This is a position that the Jews took. No, the law is still in force, buddy. I don't care who can. Whoever you believe in, the law, Moses' law is still in effect. That's the Jews' point.
Yes.
And Paul is saying that law is ended in Christ. If you accept Christ, that law is ended. So why? How? Because Christ is the end of the law for a person who's have faith in Jesus Christ as redemptive.
But has the law ended or has the punishment?
The law
actually is
the law
punishment,
ended.
Isn't it?
The law ended.
Because
if the law is ended, then it's a punishment. The law is ended.
But the law, if you break the Ten Commandments, you still got to eventually answer to God. But the punishment right here on earth may be different.
Right.
The reason why people break the law, the Ten Commandments, is because they are not walking in faith. That's why the law was broken, because they're not walking in faith. See, until I know about faith and how to walk in faith, I'm always sinning. Whatsoever is not of faith is sin. I'm always sinning if I don't know nothing about faith. That's why Paul says we were shut. We didn't have a chance until faith came. When faith came, boy, I died to the law. It's over.
Okay, so can faith come to that man who killed all the people?
Yeah.
All right then. So how can you say we're going to kill this man?
Well, no, that's civil law.
Right.
That's the civil law.
Man. I know that. No, I'm just talking to the person who is the civil law.
Well, that's why I asked the question.
I know that civil law.
Are all of the institutions lined up with the law of grace now? No, they're not.
No.
That's the question
I'm asking. No, they're not. He's in a world of trouble,
but
he's in.
You have a curse.
Both ways, by man and by God.
Yeah, he's in a world of trouble.
He's got an out by God, but not by civil.
We know that. Yeah, I'm trying to imposed upon him on the land. He's got to have a higher throne if he can get to Christ. If he can get in Christ, he'll have a higher throne working that he can't see, hear, or visualize what's going on with that throne. But if he don't get to that throne of grace, he's good for sure.
Exactly.
Yeah. Regardless of what the final decision is, you know, they put him to death. If he has gotten to the throne of grace, this death is not the end, like Brother Rob.
Right. But you're going to find people that don't want to get to the throne of grace. They want to deal with the law. That's why I would run from it fast as I can.
Some of those people, a very few of them that I heard about, Even one of them were wounded and survived, and maybe two or three of the ones who lost a loved one in that shooting, they've forgiven the shooter.
Some of them have. You're right. They're operating under grace. They're operating in faith.
But they're going to let the law do its thing.
They can't do that with the law of the land.
Right.
So for them, their conscience is clear.
Right.
With God, they good with God. The laws are still operating.
This
calls for the death penalty.
Look at verse 10. And what cause? Here it is. Right. What we've been kicking around. What cause? Which is that cause is murder. Mm-hmm. So ever shall come to you of your brethren that dwell in their cities between blood and blood, between law and commandment, statutes and judgments. You should even warn them that they trespass not against the Lord. See, this is what he's saying. He says you should warn people that you can't go around killing folk. Because that's a tough law you're going to be dealing with. Why you have to say that? People get mad, fighting. Yeah. I'm going to beat them up. I'll get scared. People do that.
Yes, they do. They sure do.
So, you know, you got to warn them. Now, there's people right now, and I can't pick up the paper, the weekly, the daily paper, without some 20, young 20, 21, 22, 23. Just get mad and pulling out a gun and shooting somebody. Do you know what you're doing? No, they don't have a, that's why he said, you got to warn them that, man. And if they don't know Christ, their life is just, whoa. And it said, even warn them that they trespass not against the Lord. And so wrath, and say his anger come upon you. Like, does not get, you think God that man was mad at that situation in?
Yes.
Oh, yeah. He's, baby killed? Young people killed? He's mad.
You was teaching about God does bad to the people too.
A bad thing's happening.
I mean, yeah, that's what I mean. But anyway, that's what I mean. The same deal as broke down there. God could have prevented this. God could have prevented this, but we never know why God
allows something like that to happen. It's a basic elementary question. How did the devil get possess that mind? How did the devil get in that guy's mind?
Well, that's the thing that we can't never forget.
See, there was something going on that
the devil is the Lord of this land.
Planted a seed in that guy's mind, the devil was
still running this.
And it's just like you said, the little baby couldn't do anything.
Yeah, see, so
God knows he wanted to protect that little baby, but.
But then again, we're living in this world belongs to who?
Little G-O-D.
And if you're not in Christ to where your mind is not spongingly taking in and absorbing all of the things, the dictates of the devil, I heard the other day that he don't even remember doing it. His mind was taken over.
You know, them doctors, they work, said he was a good actor, that he was on TV like he was just so he had premeditated, he knew what he was doing.
That's basically, you know, when you're dealing with the law, that's what basically this is saying, is that you don't have to deal, if you're not in Christ, you got to face the law. If you're in Christ, you escape the law. Christ is the end of the law. Can't be your nearby. I mean, that's just it. It's like Apostle Paul. He had abilities placed on him. They had him in shackles.
Yeah.
And then he was under house arrest. The last sentence we read about Paul, the Apostle Paul was under house arrest. But he had a free course. And the civil law got him, you know. He had something working for him behind the scenes to make stuff come out of his favor. The law came by Moses. Grace and truth came by Moses. That's why I like salvation so much. Just give me a way out.
Yes. I know.